You are watching Skyrim commentary on the Shauna channel.
So we're back here. This is where the Silver Hands hang out. I'm supposed to recover a family heirloom?
Dibella, guide us.
For the companions? And it looks like this place has not reset since the last time I was here, so this place could be empty. That would be nice. If the place is empty, I can just run in here and get my stuff and leave. I'm sure there's some spawned stuff. I was trying to stay immersed. I want to be immersed when I play this game. But when you have 900 mods installed, immersion can be broke. Your immersion can be left in ruin. This isn't how I'm supposed to die. I'm supposed to die this way. I've always died this way. Why all of a sudden it's killing me this way? No. That's wrong. That's wrong death. That's bad wrong death. I want to install real feeding again. I probably mentioned this before. I got some ESP slots available, so now I can put real feeding back in there. So, because I'm a werewolf, and when I feed on something, I expect it to be totally ravaged. You know, the meat, the person's meat is separated from their bone. That's what I want NPCs to look like when I feed on them. Yipes. I'm trying not to kill my own people.
Is that it?
I guess. When NPCs overkill, they usually have a comment like that. Is that all? Is that all there is? Are you not entertained? I don't remember this shelf being all knocked away from the wall. Why am I getting fisheye lens going on here? Or is it just my imagination? I recorded this at the proper aspect ratio, right? 16:9? With some letterboxing. My Skyrim videos, in case you haven't noticed, have letterboxing. Supposed to make the thing look cinematic. Well, that was lag.
That's the last of them.
I got enhanced blood installed. See, this is... Oh. Someone didn't switch into their... She keeps changing back. Now I know why my game freezes. Every time she switches costume, my game freezes. Usually there's someone right here. They can't hear all this noise we're making. See how it paused right there? That's when she changes her outfit. And then the minute combat starts up, she pauses the game so she can change her outfit. This guy didn't see me right now. Yeah, every time combat's over, she switches back to her farm clothes. I ended up having to uninstall her because I got to the point where she served her purpose. Can I pick that up? Whatever that is? I guess not. Can I pick that up? No. I like that she changes her outfit. She actually changes her whole body when combat starts up. She turns into an Amazon-breasted beast. But there needs to be a way she could do that much faster. The sex lab can replace bodies with body parts, no problem. And there's no lag. When I was playing this game, I wasn't noticing the pause when Adora changes her outfit, like just now. But now in the recording, I can see the obvious lag in the game when she uses her bigger sister's body. With populated forts installed, I want to say people are sleeping in here when you come in this place. So it makes this room more interesting when you unlock it. And I keep thinking, oh, we're going to have fight scenes in here. And then it's like, oh, there's nothing to kill. There's only 10 bandits in this fort? Instead of 35 bandits? You know, that kind of thing. So, the Skinner is usually in here. Okay, who are we gonna find this time? Just regular bandits? Are there any silver hands in this place? I wasn't even paying attention. Or are they just bandits? Make enough noise stepping on a shield. Why am I stepping on a shield? For the honor. Yeah, we kill everything too fast. So yeah, these are silver hands. Are these the... I want to say I still have diverse Skyrim installed. So silver hands can be any race, basically. Not just Nords or whatever. Skewer's body never erased itself from the game? That's weird.
I've got your back.
I can't move. I have some stuff.
What do you want me to carry?
Oh, she actually wears some of it? That's good.
Let's get going then.
Oh, she still wears her pants, though? That's the problem. That's an issue.
I'm right behind you. What do you want me to carry? You lead, I'll follow.
Oh, it was the moon amulet that we were after. Okay. I thought it was a werewolf in the fight scenes here, but maybe not. Sometimes I forget I should switch to being a werewolf, or maybe I was a werewolf already earlier in the daytime, so I have to wait till the next day to be a werewolf again. I need to do all the totem things with Ayla so I can get all the perks. Or when I add a perk to my character, I can then use that perk if I have the right totem that I pray to. I want to say there's a perk so that you can get well rested or rested anything when you sleep. Instead of it saying your beast blood keeps you from resting. Well, what just happened? Did my game just die? You thinking, computer? There's like no animation, just no music. I think the game crashed. That's probably what happened. So I'm starting over the game from scratch. Yeah, the game crashed. My game crashed. So, just from going outside, now hopefully I saved. Otherwise, we have to go and kill all the bad guys again. Man, this is taking forever. That's a serious crash when the attribute settings of the files have to be reset when it loads up the game again. Okay, we got some smoke. That's good. That's a good sign when smoke starts doing its thing. Maybe I have to click on the window. Yeah, I had to click on it to get my continue to show up. Okay. It's always something. Okay, we got audio. We can now start where we left off, right? These death hounds, I remember collecting dog meat and their collars, but I don't think that has anything to do with my game. Those ingredients don't do anything. I'll have to double check. I know the dog collar doesn't do anything. Unless you have mods installed. Anyway, one of these death hounds can totally, if steps aren't taken, one of these things could kill important characters in my game. Because the master vampires usually have them as pets when they invade a city. NPCs have no chance against a death hound. Okay, so I saved around this area in the hallway. You guys ready?
What was that?
What was that? Ah! Ah!
So kill the archers first. Oh no. Oh, this isn't good. Can't get back up. Okay, I'm back to normal. Got some XP just now. So I thought, you know what, let's just load. I can't remember if the game was crashing at that one spot all the time. Or if I was just being paranoid and I was manually saving and then loading from that one spot. Okay, so I guess the game crashed or something. How many times are we gonna do this?
Is someone there?
For the honor of the Baron.
How come no one's attacking me? How come you're not attacking anyone? What's going on?
Ready to go? Good. Let's get moving.
Skewer. What happened to your outfit? I thought you had an outfit. Did it get broken?
Ready to go?
Try this again. We got everything, right?
I'm right behind you.
No, I'm not gonna marry you.
What do you want me to carry? Lead on.
Okay, let's go out here. Hopefully it won't crash. Yeah, they always get caught on that stupid fire pit thing. Can't they just walk around it? You guys coming? She's holding a spear weird. I guess they hold spears like they hold swords. I noticed my game, it takes forever to load the outdoor or the indoor when going through a door. Okay, I want to go to... We still haven't done Kynesgrove yet? No, that's crazy. There's something going on in Kynesgrove. You guys coming? Good.
Behold my power.
Now who are they murdering? We're just murder hobos at this point. That was neat. She had like a black thing going on. What was that? She was like a mist. Maybe she grabs a ring or a necklace and puts it on. Because I made her a ring or necklace. Anyway, I made some jewelry that works with her, maybe. So that's why I'm able to sell to the same NPC more often than just once a week. I noticed that my game will crash if I fuss with any of the most minute items laying around. It's almost like a blue flower will be in bloom or it won't be in bloom. And when I pick it, depending on if it's bloom or not, it might crash the game. Or, oh, what's this? Not good. Do I have a shout that works on giants? Ooh! That's gotta hurt. Come on, make your suit. Okay, so the suit... The suit of hers didn't interfere too much in killing that giant. But I want to try it again. It seemed lame the way we killed her. For the honor. Come on! So now she's not, what do they call it, overburdened as a monster NPC. I just get to do I can't believe we haven't. What are we doing exactly? Uh-oh. It's like whenever I turn a certain direction, everything goes dark. This is weird.
No, you don't want to go up there. A dragon, it's attacking.
Well, I don't know. Not yet. It flew over the town and landed on the old dragon mound. I don't know what it's doing up there, but I'm not waiting around to find out.
I'm supposed to meet Delphine up here. See? There's like these dragon wings. Showing up at weird angles when I move the camera. The dragon's not flying. The dragon's like parked on the ground. This is which dragon are you? And then it moves all weird when I move sideways. Weird. So I want to say I removed a mod that changed Alduin's appearance. And then I decided to put back an Alduin mod that I was using earlier that made Alduin look amazing. So right now I'm in the, Nexus Mod Manager. Ripping out that mod that changes the skin and the mesh of Alduin. Or at least going on Nexus. Maybe I'm going on Nexus to see if anyone mentions a problem with him or not. Maybe that's what I did. I just went on the internet. Because I want to say going back into Skyrim didn't fix it. The wing was still like blocking my way up the path to the dragon burial site. So I thought I would go back here to this point. Maybe some settings in wet and cold. Temporarily turn things off just so I can get a better look at what the dragon is doing. When it should be flying, instead it's on the ground, being pushed around. It's like the dragon, the animation for the dragon doesn't match the skeleton that the dragon has. And this Alduin mod was one of those mods where a guy, he posts the mod and then a month later he gets his channel nuked. It'll say user account deleted, which is weird. So many players get their user accounts deleted. I don't know if they're doing that on purpose, or if they're getting banned from Nexus mods. Or they have both Nexus mods and Steam Workshop files installed at the same time. That's an easy enough thing to do, but it can get kind of clunky when you start working with load orders from each one. Anyway, so we just run to Kynes Grove again. And there's the wing. And the wing, I want to say the triangle for the wing stretches all the way into infinity.
No, you don't want to go up there. A dragon, it's attacking.
Where are you? Oh, there you are.
It flew over the town and landed on the... I don't know what it's doing up there, but I'm not
skip,
waiting around to find out.
Skip, 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 skip. And there's the wing again. Okay, there's Delphine. So the wing gets in the way. I can't see squat. And I want to say the tail of the dragon gets pulled on. When Alduin's flying, his mesh stretches off into infinity. So it's starting to make sense now what's going on. This is something you almost never see in the game until a crap mod author releases a mod. I don't think his body even looks like the one I chose to use.